I would like to touch briefly on a subject that I think you'll find most amazing, that I write about in the introductory section titled The Bonus Level in the Messianic Aleph Tav Scriptures. And I introduce you to the Aleph Tav in relation with other single Hebrew letters as a prefix. This is where the message begins to get even more interesting, and it's why I encourage everyone who is purchasing the Messianic Aleph Tav Scriptures to read the introduction first, so that they can better understand and appreciate their Matt's study Bible once they have received it. Now, this is truly amazing, because the association of other Hebrew letters as a prefix of the Aleph Tav character symbol only serves to substantiate the validity that the Aleph Tav symbol represents Yeshua in relationship with the Yah-head. What you are about to learn, I believe, has been hidden in plain sight and mistranslated and misrepresented to the masses for hundreds of years, as I will show you. And the significance of this knowledge should not be underestimated, for it is unprecedented. It will be important to become familiar with these Hebrew letters that are connected to the Aleph Tav as a prefix in order to draw a more comprehensive meaning of what the author was trying to communicate, whether it was Moses or the prophets, because most of these words are not used that often in the Tanakh, and this is what makes them so very special and important. We have already covered the importance of the Vav Aleph Tav word in an earlier video, so let's talk about the Zayin Aleph Tav Hebrew word. And bear in mind that there are many Hebrew words that just don't have an equivalent in the English language to be translated into, and the Zayin Aleph Tav, I believe, is just such a word. The Hebrew letter is believed to actually be a Hebrew letter Vav with a crown on top, and is believed that the letter represents the Messiah. Now, isn't that interesting? The sages reasoned this from the combining of the meaning of the two letters. The Vav is symbolic of a man, and the meaning of the Zayin is a weapon, such as a sword. Thus, Yeshua, our Messiah, is then crowned as King of Kings, who is the Word made flesh, which is sharper than any two-edged sword. So it is a very special letter indeed. And when the Zayin is combined with the Aleph Tav, it becomes even more special. For the word is used 251 times in the Tanakh in some very interesting places, as I will show you. And they are all placed in the Messianic Aleph Tav Scriptures. The seventh letter in the Aleph Bet, the original Hebrew letter Zayin, as I said, was believed to represent a weapon, which means to cut, or to cut up, or cut off. And when you see where the Zayin Aleph Tav word is placed in Scripture, you'll realize immediately how dynamic this word truly is, because it is used in regard to the Yah-head doing some serious cutting, either to bring a blessing or to bring a curse. Pronounced Zoath in Hebrew, the first time the Zayin Aleph Tav word is used as a blessing in Genesis 2:23, when the Yah-head cuts a rib from Adam's side to form woman, which reads, "And said Adam, Zayin Aleph Tav is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. Lamed Zayin Aleph Tav will be called woman, because out of man was taken Zayin Aleph Tav." Apparently, the King James English translators didn't know what to do with this word and translated it as the English word this. But again, please bear in mind that the Torah was originally written in Paleo-Hebrew, a primitive pictorial language, and it is highly unlikely that conjunctions or subordinate conjunctions or definite and indefinite articles or even adjectives existed in Paleo-Hebrew until the Masoretes began adding vowel points to the language of Babylonian Hebrew. in the 8th and 10th century AD. And it is even more likely that there are some Hebrew words that there is just no English equivalent for. And the Zayin Aleph Tav, I believe, just may be one of those words. For what Moses was pointing to, a new creation that came out of Adam, and he seems to be implying that the woman was cut from Adam's rib by the Yah-head when she was created, which takes her creation to a whole new level of understanding by the placement of the Zayin Aleph Tav. And to make matters even more interesting, also notice the Hebrew letter Lamed in the text, which means staff or authority in front of the Zayin Aleph Tav word. Could this word be implying when the woman was created, she was also given equal authority as Adam when she was Zayin Aleph Tav, or cut from Adam by the Aleph Tav? Consequently, the meaning Moses was trying to portray in Paleo-Hebrew from where woman had been created must have been far more meaningful in the mind of Moses than the English translation indicates as the word this. Bear in mind that the translators also translate other Hebrew words as this. In fact, the English word this is used a total of 1,971 times in the Old Testament Tanakh, and the English translators have translated over a dozen different Hebrew words as either this or containing the English word this. And please remember, the English word this more than likely didn't exist in Paleo-Hebrew. So if you are beginning to see that translating Hebrew is not an exact science, join the club. But that is what makes this language so fascinating, because there is still so much to be learned from the language the Almighty used to speak creation into existence. This is why Jewish rabbis gather in schools in Israel and study Hebrew constantly, because they are still trying to figure out hidden truth. They know they must let the Hebrew letters speak for themselves if they are to truly gain a more comprehensive meaning to what the author was trying to say. We do not have to look too far to see the Zayin Aleph Tav word used as an example of rendering a curse or judgment from the Yah-head. The word is used again to describe their disobedience when they fall in Genesis 3:13, which states, "And said Yahuwah Elohim to the woman, what is Zayin Aleph Tav that you have done? And the woman said, the serpent tricked me, and I ate it. And said Yahuwah Elohim to the serpent, because you have done Zayin Aleph Tav, you are cursed above all cattle and every wild beast of the field." Implying now, because of their Zayin Aleph Tav disobedience in breaking Elohim's command, as a result, Adam and Eve and Lucifer had taken on a curse from the Yah-head. Consequently, as punishment to Eve, she apparently forfeited her authority, as verse 16 states, that now Adam would rule over her, thus being her covering. So by understanding the profound meaning of the Zayin Aleph Tav, we see the seriousness in what took place at the fall, whereby the covenant was broken by their Zayin Aleph Tav disobedience to the Yah-head, and their crime was against the Aleph Tav, as their punishment came from the Aleph Tav that they struck. And we see all this by reasoning of the meaning of the Zayin Aleph Tav. So when you see where this word is used throughout the Tanakh in the Messianic Aleph Tav scriptures, it will give you a whole new meaning to what the authors were really trying to convey that the translators completely missed. I'm Bill Sanford, trying to put the Aleph Tav in proper perspective in our day. Shalom.